Welcome to us class assembly. Please join us as we make the sign of the cross.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
This morning our assembly is all about Advent. The word Advent comes from the Latin word Adventus, meaning coming. This Sunday will be the first Sunday of Advent, which marks the start of the new church year.
Advent starts 4 Sundays before Christmas Day. So this year it begins on Sunday the 29th of November. As we get ready to enter the special season, we light our candle to remind us that Jesus is coming to light up the darkness. Please join us as we listen to Are You Ready for the Light?
Look, it's nice to do all those things in Advent, but you're missing the point. Do you know what Advent is actually for? Well, first of all, Christmas is not just about getting presents. It is Jesus' birthday, so on Christmas Day we celebrate his birth and thank God for the most amazing gift that he gave us. In fact, without Jesus, there would be no Christmas at all, so you probably wouldn't be getting all those presents. And because Jesus' birth is such an amazing mystery, 4 weeks have been especially dedicated to waiting for him to come and preparing our hearts and lives to receive him. That time is called Advent. Here, watch this.
A long time ago, God created the world and everything in it. Then God created people to love and care for his world. It was all good, and for a time, people were happy and the world was perfect. But something went terribly wrong. The people disobeyed God. They chose to follow their own plans instead. This meant that a curse entered the world because of sin.
The curse brought pain and sorrow into their lives, but the world was still beautiful. But because of the curse, it was broken. Worst of all, the curse separated people from God instead of living with him forever. They died. This made God sad. So God spoke to his people through his prophets. Prophets were people who were very close to God, so he could speak to them. The prophets listened carefully to God's message, and then they told God's people what he had said.
Because people disobeyed God, the prophets told them, "You have sinned. for so much that he didn't like finishing them all the time. So he had a plan for that. The most amazing plan ever.
God promised that he would send a king to save and restore his people forever. This savior would take the punishment for our sins so we wouldn't be in trouble anymore and we could come closer to God. The prophets told God's people about his promise to send a king, a savior for us all. God didn't tell them when or where this king would come, but they knew that he would come, for they trusted God's promise. So the prophets waited patiently and got ready for the coming savior. The prophets did their best to make God's people listen and wait for him too.
To tell Mary that she was to have a baby. God said to she should call Jesus. She must have been so shocked and a little frightened too. But she trusted God and so she agreed to do what he asked her.
Soon after the angel visited Mary's Bethlehem, Joseph in a dream. The angel told him that Mary would be having the son of God, just like Mary did, trusted in God and understood that this was part of his plan. When Mary was heavily pregnant, she had Joseph. She and Joseph had to make a long and difficult journey.
At last, God had fulfilled his promise for us.
In the video, we heard how God's people had waited for Jesus for thousands of years. They never gave up hope and always trusted in the promise that God would send a savior, and he did.
So during the season of Advent, we look forward to Christmas Day with great joy and hope as we get ready to celebrate that very special day when God sent his son, Jesus Christ, down to earth.
There are so many traditions that we have during this joyful season of Advent, which help us to really prepare for Jesus' birthday. Every day during Advent, children open Advent calendars. Behind each door is a special symbol to remind us of the Christmas story.
During Advent, many people have parties to spend time with their family and friends. We also go shopping to buy Christmas gifts for people we love. This reminds us that God gave the world the greatest gift ever, His own Son.
During Advent, we prepare our homes by decorating them with Christmas trees, bright shining lights, and festive, colourful decorations.
In Christian homes and churches, we will often see the nativity scenes, which help us to remember the key figures in the Christmas story. In school, children perform nativity plays to tell us of the story. Some people have a Jesus tree in their homes or their classrooms, which celebrates the lives of Jesus ancestors, including Song of the Progress.
But Advent is not just a time of getting ready for Jesus' birthday, because that wasn't the end of God's plan. Jesus has promised us that one day He will come again. We don't know when He will come, but we know that He will, because He always keeps His promises.
So Advent is time to wait, watch, and get ready for the second coming of King Jesus. Let us listen to Awake as we prepare to greet the gospel.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to His disciples, "Stay awake, for you do not know on which day your Lord will come. Be sure of this. If the master of the house had known the hour of the night, when the thief was coming, he would have stayed awake and not let his house be broken into. So too, you also must be prepared, for at an hour you do not expect, the Son of Man will come." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
This Gospel reading in church during gathering. In the reading, Jesus tells us that we must stay awake and be prepared for when Jesus returns. So during Advent, while we wait for Jesus, we spend time getting ready for Him.
But what does that mean? How exactly can we stay awake and be ready for when He comes back for us? Well, just as we prepare our homes for Advent, we should also prepare ourselves to ensure that our homes are open and ready to let Jesus in. To do this, we can try our best by following the light of God and listening to His word. We can put time aside each day to pray and spend time with God.
Advent also is a good opportunity of Catholics to go to conference by asking for their sins to be forgiven. Many of us in Year 3 will be making our first reconciliation this Advent.
We can also try to be more like Jesus during Advent by sharing His message of love and compassion. For example, we could help other people who are in need. We can give money to charity. We can spend time with people who are lonely, and we can show forgiveness towards other people.
An important Christmas tradition in Catholic churches and schools is the Advent wreath. We light the candles of the Advent wreath each week during Advent, and it helps us to focus and reflect on Jesus as we wait for Christmas Day. bottom of the wreath is beautiful because the evergreen leaves represent God's eternal love for us, and the circular shape shows that his love has no beginning and no end. The wreath has four candles.
Prophets who created and trusted and proclaimed the news that the Savior Jesus was to come.
We light the second candle on the second Sunday of Advent. This candle represents peace and delight as we remember the Holy Family Mary and Joseph who prepared to bring the special King into the world.
The third candle is lit on the third Sunday of the event, unlike the others. This candle is pink because it represents joy. Gratitude is the special word meaning rejoice. This week, we think about the joy of the shepherds who were the first ones to hear the good news and to meet the baby Jesus.
The fourth candle is lit on the final Sunday of Advent. This represents love, and we light it as we think about the wise men who traveled so far to welcome the baby Jesus.
The final candle is lit on Christmas Day. This is the Christ candle. It is white and it is special because it shows that Jesus is finally here with us.
Heavenly Father, as we prepare for Christmas, help us to find time in our busy life for work and prayer so that we may reflect upon the wonder of the Lord. Please join us as we pray. The response is, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for Pope Francis, Archbishop Bernard, and Father Tony as they continue to lead and inspire us through our Advent journey. May they prepare the way of the Lord by their preaching and the witness of their lives. Lord, in your mercy.
Let us pray for those countries who will not experience the peace of Christ this Advent because of war and conflict. May the leaders of these nations work together to achieve peaceful solutions to their problems. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Let us pray for Sacred Heart School and Park community and members of our own families. Those Advent will be filled with worries, illness, or loneliness. Let us ask that we may be willing to reach out to them and assist them in their every need. Lord, in your mercy.
Let us pray for the children in year six who will have an extremely special year ahead. May they be filled with the fruit and gifts of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray for the children in year three who will be soon receiving the sacrament of birth and reconciliation. May they feel the love and mercy of God. Lord, in your mercy.
Let us pray for ourselves that as we prepare for Christmas Day, we may stay awake, be ready, and watch for the coming of our Lord and Master, so that our hearts are places that He can find a home. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Now take a few quiet moments in the stillness of your heart. Going to talk to God and ask Him to help you prepare for Jesus' Advent.
We would like to finish with a song called Savior Coming.
One day this world will see Jesus returning. Let's trust God so deeply that we look for Him with excitement every single day.
A happy
the Advent octave, let us make the sign of the cross.
Name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
King of love.